In a future where cyborgs rule, Alex has shown us a way to retaliate by training the perfect weapon against tyranny. Ari Frost, prototype for a superior race of humans, free from genetic enhancements, groomed to defeat the Red Army Hammerheads. In a hostile world where life is dangerous, she must form an army of cyborg humans to take down the regime. But first, Ari must destroy the ultimate killing machine. Transported through time to save our race. The epic battle for evolution or extinction will end.
Goddamn bitch cop.
Ari must triumph.
Let's see what little Miss Safer will just do.
And the leader of the Red Army Hammerheads must be stopped. Nemesis 5.
Without you, the strides we have made would never have been possible.
Hi everyone, I'm Dawna Heising, and we're here with Ion Entertainment and Dustin Ferguson.
Face blast makeup done. Where's Heather?
Outside.
Someone get Heather, we need to do this now.
In my 20s, you know, I picked up a camera, started making my own short films, and have kind of progressed to where I'm at now. The film we're doing now, Nemesis 5, is my 50th feature film.
And look how young he is. So that gives you an idea of how amazing he is. Okay, now, what got you interested in the film business?
Just being a fan myself. You know, I grew up a fan of horror movies, watching all the old classics on VHS, and decided as I got older that I wanted to make those too because I enjoyed them so much. So I started making, you know, like kind of campier B-horror films, and I've slowly progressed into more mainstream material and doing a sci-fi action movie with Nemesis now.
Okay, now, Nemesis is a franchise. It's a legendary franchise, actually. So, tell us how this came about.
Well, I'm a fan, you know, of the series, and one day I was just sitting in my video store kind of looking up at this poster, you know, daydreaming a little bit about it, and I'm like, I would love to make a sequel to that. And so I, you know, contacted Albert Pune on Facebook and basically told him I was a big fan of the series, and I thought it'd be really fun to make a sequel, you know, 20 years later and kind of wrap everything up in the story. And he was really receptive to it, and he's like, well, you know, shoot me some ideas and we'll talk. And so I sent him an outline, and he was really happy, and he told us to move forward. We gave him a script, and he told us to go for it.
Okay, now tell us about the script.
Okay, well, Mike Reeve wrote the script. This, I believe, is the first project he wrote for me. He also wrote Conjuring Curse, which was the film I just wrapped that we were doing at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
Mike actually started out as a customer at my old video store, Old School Video. Mm-hmm. He was coming in on a regular basis, and he is also a poster dealer. He deals movie posters and memorabilia. And so that's actually how I got the Nemesis poster. He brought it in and put it on my wall with a Part 2 poster, and that's kind of how this all began.
Mm-hmm.
So it was really crazy, you know, it's kind of come full circle.
Mm-hmm.
The script itself is, it's like a sequel and a re-imaging of the original story. We kind of go back in time to recon some events to wrap everything up. So we have all the best elements from the series. We've got the cool cyborg twin killers from number 2 and the Nebula. Mm-hmm. We've got, you know, of course, the Red Army Hammerheads. We've got a lot of really cool elements from the whole series that really it's for the fans. Because 20 years later, you know, it's really, we're catering to the fans. There's not a huge outside audience yet for this.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's really important to us to do it right. And so the fans are going to really enjoy the watch.
Okay, now this has been a really long process. How long have you been shooting?
Oh gosh, it's been over 2 months. For me, that's a long time. Most of my films are like a week.
I know.
And yeah, this has been quite some time, but it's worth it. You know, we're putting a lot of work into it. There's a lot of special effects, a lot of fight choreography, some really good locations. We spent a lot of time with the cinematography because it needs to look spectacular.
Mm-hmm.
So we're really taking our time with it, kind of shooting it on weekends. It's a big cast and crew. I think on the first day we had roughly 30 people on set. It was madness, you know, like, and so we had to orchestrate that with everyone's schedules. So we're really doing it right.
And how do you know Skylar?
Skylar I met through a music video audition. In 2015, we shot two music videos for a band called Dragon's Claw that was actually kind of like this, where it was post-apocalyptic, like a gang on rollerblades, you know, in the future.
Mm-hmm.
And so we met on that, and we've kind of always worked together since. She's appeared in several videos. I'd say at least 7 or 8 of my features at this point. So she's really, she's a great person. She's a beautiful model. You know, she's very talented. So we're really happy to have her as the lead in this.
Okay, and then tell us about Sue Price.
Oh, well, you know, Sue Price is legendary with the series. You know, she's in parts 2, 3, and 4. And so, of course, we thought it was 100% necessary to bring her back for this to kind of tie everything up. You know, it's what the fans would want. So we got in contact with her, and we flew her down here, and she was in the first 2 days of shooting, and all her stuff came out really good. So we're really excited to have her as part of the film.
Okay, Sue is amazing. You have to see the trailer for Nemesis 4. I mean, she's a bodybuilder.
Yes.
And you also had Diane Azzura.
Yep, Diane Azzura was there. She was in the opening scene as one of the cyborg terrorists. That is basically the first person that Skyler faces off with in the film, as an adult.
Move and I'll crush your throat.
It was a long shoot, and yeah, like I said, there's about 30 people involved, but it'll really show when the movie's finished.
Okay, now tell us about the Doom Buggies.
Oh gosh. Okay, so, you know, the series has always sort of been like Mad Max meets Blade Runner with a little Terminator thrown in. So that's kind of what we ran with the look and feel of the movie. I thought it would be really necessary to have something like sort of a tribute scene to something like that, like a montage of traveling through the wasteland. So we got this big heavy-duty Jeep, and we went out with a drone last weekend out in western Nebraska and shot a whole bunch of footage of it just driving through the wasteland area. And it's actually, that's the connection to Diane Azzura, because she is the front woman of a band called Pandora Black. And they lent us 2 songs for the film, and so that sequence in the movie is set to 1 of her songs.
Oh, how exciting. I can't wait to see it. Okay, now tell us about the producer. How did the funding come through?
Well, you know, Albert Pune is listed as the associate producer, and then we have Mark Popejoy, who's a friend of mine, and he's acted in some of my films, and he's recently got into producing. A good friend of his basically gave us most of the budget, and then everything else were little amounts, basically from everybody that was just a fan of the series. We were able to put all the money together that way and really pull the project together. So I would say there's close to 8 or 9 producers on this movie.
Wow, so Randy is...
Randy is a good friend of Mark Popejoy, and he is from Colorado, I believe.
Oh, he is? Oh, okay. Oh, well, great. Okay, now you've got a bit of a life change coming up, so tell us about that.
Yeah, well, next week I'm going to be relocating to California. I signed a 4-picture deal with Wild Eye Releasing, so I start the first one next month. So I'm gearing up to get rid of all my stuff and relocate out there and start my life there.
Okay, and why did you decide to come to California?
The opportunity. You know, I feel like it was interesting because when I started Nemesis 5, I had no intentions of leaving Nebraska. But now at the end of Nemesis 5, I feel like everything has changed. You know, my perspective's a little bit different. Mm-hmm. I feel a little bit more ambitious even than I did before. I've overcome certain challenges I didn't think I could. And I feel really ready for it. You know, it feels like the next natural step for me. So I'm really excited to do it.
Now, you're... you know, I've known you for a while now. Now, I know that you have a head for business. A lot of filmmakers would love to get a deal with a production company. How did you go about it?
I've been in contact with Wild Eye Releasing for some time. My first film, Amityville Legacy, with them, I did in 2016, and they were really happy with it, so I went and made a sequel called Amityville Evil Never Dies that you were in.
Okay.
With Mark Patton. And after that, you know, we've just been in touch, and I told them about my ideas for moving out to California and that I was looking for some steady work. He's like, you know, let's do a picture deal and give you some work. And we came up with some ideas for what we're going to do for the pictures, and we're both really happy with it, and it's going to give me, you know, the income I need to survive out there. So it all kind of worked out perfect.
Okay, well, that is really amazing. I'm here in Nebraska to shoot my scene in the film, and it's kind of a surprise, so we won't talk about that. But let me ask you about, you're a great editor. How did you learn your skills?
I started out just doing, you know, fan projects on the internet. And I was kind of discovered that way, and I was actually hired to do Sleepaway Camp 4 back in 2009. And so I kind of broke into the industry with that film.
Okay, and what do you use, and did you teach yourself?
Yeah, I'm completely self-taught. I use Sony's Vegas, which isn't really the industry standard. Most people use, you know, Final Cut Pro.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I'm completely self-taught. I just started with my own projects and just kind of learned from my own mistakes and got to where I'm at today doing that.
Okay, and are you doing the CGI in the film?
I'm not. Actually, we hired a guy named Ryan Daly. He's doing all the CG work, and he's also doing a little bit of Conjuring Curse for me, too. He's done some other stuff. He's super talented, you know. I've been really blown away with everything in the film. I mean, there was so much work that was going to have to go into this to give it the right look, and he's just nailed it. You know, I think he's a fan of the series himself, so he really understands what we're really trying to achieve with it, and it's spot on.
Okay, well, great. I'm excited about shooting tomorrow, and
yes.
Thank you for this interview.
Thank you, Dawna. It's always a pleasure. I'm here with my star, Skylar Craig.
Hi.
Skylar, why don't you tell us a little bit of how you became involved with the film?
Yeah, so I heard about the film from Dustin, and he asked me if I wanted to be the lead Ari Frost in the film, and I said yes, and then he said, you have to go through 10 weeks of combat training, and I said, that's okay, I totally wanted to do it, so it looks like a cool film to get on, so.
So we've worked together in quite a few movies. Why don't you talk a little bit about some of the other stuff we've done together and how this is different?
Yeah, so we usually kind of stay around the horror genre. This is kind of our first action sci-fi film that we've done. We did The Dummy 2 not too long ago. That was a lot of fun. Probably the most epic performance I felt like from my part, besides we did Camp Blood 4 and 5 together, and then Shockumentary. Yeah.
We had Blood Claws,
yes, and then I've made some appearances here and there in some of your other films, yeah.
Totally. So, are you a fan of the sci-fi and action genre?
I am, so I'm a Trekkie, so everyone's like all Star Wars and I'm a Trekkie, but no, I do enjoy it. I think it's really interesting. It's a lot of fun. Being able to actually kind of come out of your comfort zone and do something new. I've never done any combat training whatsoever, so this was it was a new experience for me, and being able to work alongside some of the most talented people was just amazing and insane.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah.
So, like, would you say was one of the most memorable experiences for filming?
Wow. Put me on the spot. There's so many good ones. I think probably when we went out to the dunes, that was a lot of fun. I actually got to drive the Jeep, which Mark let me drive the Jeep, and that was really cool because I was like, hey, I really want to drive the Jeep. So, I got to do that. And probably our fight scenes today with Dawna and with Sean, because it kind of got to show all the stuff that we've been practicing and really portray that in such a way that shows how I am so against, you know, the Red Army and, you know, how that conflicts and how much pressure there is against that, so.
Oh, yeah. And obviously we brought back Sue Price from the series.
We did.
She was sort of like your mother,
adopted
mother. Why don't you talk a little bit about what it was like working with her?
Man, Sue was great. She was so nice. She was so kind. She's so small. I just loved her the minute that I met her. Watching her do Nemesis 2 and 3, she was just astounding. Like, she's so physically and like enabling, so to me, here I am, like, watching her be a badass, and I have to literally become that badass. So it was a little intimidating at first, but, no, working with her was amazing. She was very skilled and listened really well and to, like, all the cues of the fighting, and we worked really well together, I thought. And, no, she was just great. She was amazing. And
yeah.
Inspiration, for sure.
The dynamic between the two of you, you know, worked really well, and it was interesting because she sort of passed the torch to you, and that's kind of making you the lead.
Mm-hmm.
So all the roles you had prior, you'd had like co-starring roles, you had a couple leads here and there, but this is the first role I think that you've done in a feature film that had so much meat. And I think what's interesting about it is it's going to really develop its own following for you. You know, you carrying the torch, you're like the center of attention for Nemesis 5. So I think, you know, with that said, what would you like to say to your fans that are following you up through this whole journey that you
To my fans, thank you so much for being so supportive of me throughout all of my career. Honestly, without you guys, and especially the fans of Nemesis, none of this would be possible because we rely on you guys, and we appreciate all of your feedback and your love and your support, and it's just been an insane, incredible experience. I'm so eternally grateful for literally everyone, and I always try to make it one of my points to, you know, make sure that, you know, just because I'm the lead, that doesn't mean I get all the credit. You know, like the directors, the producers, all the people that are doing everything behind the scenes. You know, Sean, who basically trained me for this role, was an essential part. And then my co-stars are just fantastic. So I just thank you to all of you guys too, because without you guys, Nemesis 5 wouldn't be as amazing as it is.
Exactly. It was definitely a group effort. I think that we all have a lot to be proud of, and I hope that the fans enjoy it as well.
Me too.
Agreed. Okay, we're here with Sean Vitek, and he's the stunt coordinator on Nemesis 5. Well, how did you start working with Dustin?
I remember meeting Dustin at a couple parties where we were just like introducing stuff we were working on, and I was producing a movie at the time, and Dustin was producing movies, and we just like met at parties showing our work with mutual friends of ours, Dorothy Borium, Chad Hofschild. Mm-hmm. And just chatted at the parties, and then he invited me onto his next project. I think I did sound the first time. I've done all kinds of aspects. I've produced and written and done sound. And
oh, I didn't know that. Okay, well then tell us how you got started in the film.
Around the same time when I got divorced.
Okay. Well, that's
when Life 2.0 starts.
Okay.
And I helped found this film group in Omaha called the Nebraska Film Group, and we had an office downtown, and we facilitated like lots of auditions and tried to help people put together crews and cast and just facilitate other people's work. And
Have you always been interested in film?
Yeah, well, I mean, when I grew up on a horse ranch, like cable TV was kind of not necessarily a thing for me, and broadcast was about it. And every now and then I'd see a movie and I'd be like, wow. And and I wouldn't always have like the tape to play it over and over again. Or if I recorded some things you could record on tape, I would watch it over and over again until it was worn out. And I remember my memory of movies wasn't always perfect. Like I'd watch the movie a second time like years later and I'd be like, wow, I filled a lot of gaps with my mind. And I was totally wrong. That's not what really happened in the movie. And so it kind of, in a way, I felt like it made me a lot more creative to watch movies and talk about movies. And so it was just really interesting. I guess I've always been kind of creative in that way, like where I would make up plays or copy characters for movies and stuff. And sword fighting with my brother, you know, grabbing sticks in the backyard. And rough play was like always a huge part of it. Like, we had whips, and we thought we were Indiana Jones.
Okay.
Stuff like that. It was fun.
Okay, now, is Nemesis 5 the first thing that you've choreographed stunts for?
No, I've done a lot of choreography. I've worked with quite a few people. First one being Blood Rites for Chad Hofschild and Dorothy Borium, as we mentioned.
Uh-huh.
And that might have been right after that when I met Dustin. And I choreograph, a lot of times I choreograph my own death. I teach people how to kill me.
Okay.
That seems to happen a lot.
Well, that's great. Because
I'm big and maybe I look like a villain.
Okay. So how many fight scenes have you choreographed for a Nemesis 5?
Oh, that's a good question. I don't know, 5, 6? Something like that, yeah.
Really? Oh,
yeah,
okay.
There's a bunch of different fights and stunts and stuff, and it's pretty fun because we get moving pretty fast, and it's like, this person's down, and that person's down. You know, you put the mat over there to keep this guy safe, and it moves well. It's fun.
Oh, okay, great. Well, I can't wait to work with you.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, Sean's here to work with me for Nemesis 5.
Yeah, she's going to kick some butt, that's for sure.
You're gonna make me look like an expert.
Okay. Yeah, sure. Okay. Yeah. You versus Skylar is, it'll be good.
Okay, great.
Hi, my name is Joe Williamson, and we're here with the legendary screen villain Mel Novak. And now we're here talking about one of Mel's newest projects. We plays one of it. This could be one of your greatest villain roles, in a way.
Yeah, you start a 50-year war. That's not a good guy. But it's exciting. I'm really glad to be here.
No, we're like I said, we're really excited about this project. You know, and Nemesis. You know, Nemesis is a great science fiction thriller. You know, sci-fi, martial arts, action type movie. You know, and you kind of started that with The Ultimate Warrior with Yul Brynner. That was the first film that inspired like Mad Max and then like yeah. Nemesis as well.
And I love these type of films. It's really close to my heart.
Now, in Nemesis, tell us about your character. And he has a good heart. He seems to mean well, you know, or is he just pure evil? What would you say?
Well, I don't know how mean well you could be if you cause a 50-year war. And he has that controlling, demanding, manipulative spirit that gets what he wants. Self-made man who admires his maker. And it's a different kind of character, which I like challenges.
He's kind of like a twisted hero. He wants to make the world a better place, make it pure, no matter how many people have to die. And like I said, the Nemesis films is...
Classic. They're classic.
Yeah, I love the Nemesis franchise, and we're glad for Dustin, the brilliant producer-director, to be bringing them back. You know, it's a whole new generation.
Excited to work with him. He's had over 50 films.
No, Dustin's got an incredible body of work, like I said, I'm really excited to work with him. And he's not only a brilliant artist and great filmmaker, but also an awesome human being, too, and a great heart, too.
That's very important, especially in this business.
When he's not killing people in the movies. Yeah. But no, like I said, this film here, Nemesis, it's kind of a combination of Mad Max and Blade Runner.
Yes.
You know, it's and it's got maybe even a little bit of Ultimate Warrior in there as well. If you want to see a science fiction action movie, we definitely recommend Nemesis Part 5. And then while you're at it, check out some of the other Nemesis. And you know, if you're not familiar with the franchise, please check out some of the other ones as well.
Yeah, check out Dustin's
body of work.
Body of work, too.
No, and this is a nice change for Dustin, too, because he's... although he's known for best doing thrillers and horror films, now it's nice that he's shown that he's, you know, expanding his base and much more he can do too, which he can. You know, there's a lot of great directors out there, like Bob Clark, which started in horror films, and then he went on to do famous Christmas Story. You know, it's a nice starting point, the horror films. But anyway, so don't miss Nemesis. Thank you so much, Mel, for coming.
My pleasure.
We have executive producer Mark and producer Randy. So, welcome to Ion Entertainment.
Hi.
Hi. Tell us a little bit how you got involved in the project.
Thanks, Dawna. As you said, I'm an executive producer on the film, and I met the director, Dustin Ferguson, some years ago, working on multiple projects, being music videos, films, and those kind of things, and just became friends with Dustin over the years. And when he mentioned that he was doing a Nemesis 5, an Albert Pune film, I came to Dustin and I asked him if I could be a part of it and help out and help produce and help raise financing and help production management and whatever it is that I could do to help out, and if he had any roles for me in the film as well, because I do like to act as well. So I talked to Dustin about coming on board and helping him produce this film. And he kind of knew that this was a bigger undertaking than what he was, you know, I want to say it was a different type of project than what he was used to.
Well, this is sci-fi action.
Yeah, sci-fi action, right. So I just asked him if he needed some help, and he said, yeah, I would love to have some help, and anything you can do to help out. I mean, we just kind of tackled it. from that point of view, you know, what he wasn't able to do, I tried to pick up.
Mm-hmm.
And if he asked me to, hey, I need you to do this, I tried to pick it up.
Yeah,
and,
I've been so impressed. I mean, it's like you're a go-getter, just like Dustin.
Yeah, it worked very well together. I'm happy with the way that the collaboration came together.
Uh-huh. And so Randy is your friend.
Yeah, Randy's
a
good friend of mine.
Me and Mark known each other for 30 years. We went to high school together. And
where?
Brian High in Omaha, Nebraska.
In Omaha, Nebraska.
Oh, okay.
So he told me about the project, and I had a little bit of extra money and thought it'd be cool to get in the movie business. Never been in it before, and I'm having fun.
You're amazing, Randy.
Thank you.
We're so blessed.
Yeah.
And where do you live?
I live in Denver, Colorado.
Okay, so you moved out there and you had your printing company.
Yeah, I was a lead press operator at a big web printing company, magazines, and
uh-huh.
I just retired because it came in a little bit of money, and now I'm doing other things.
Okay.
Now he's a producer.
I know. I like movie making. He was a YouTube
Right. I enjoyed myself today. It was the first time I had anything to do with watching a movie being made, and it was I had a good time.
Yeah, that's great.
Yeah,
okay, well, I mean, he was on the set today too, so thank you very much for your major contributions to this film.
Thanks, Randy.
Thank you.
Appreciate you.